Now, the first thing I like to do is add the palest colours first, and we can gradually build up on those paler colours as I go through the painting process. So start off lighter and gradually get darker as you go along. So overlaying the permanent pen as well. It's got to be permanent ink, by the way, otherwise it'll obviously just blur and run underneath the watercolour paint. Increasing the strength of the colours you go along as well, so I'm going to add more pigment and less water as I go through the painting process. But then you've also got to consider the overall shape at the same time, so where it's going to be kind of richer in tone, darker as well, like underneath the belly, as you can see here. So therefore you've got to increase the pigment quantity and also reduce the amount of water that you add within that paint as well. So more pigment, less water, and keep checking it as you go along, looking for those darker areas, but don't go really dark, because remember, we've already got the detail on the paper using that permanent pen, haven't we? So the overall idea here is to add that zap of colour to really bring this painting to life.